Hi folks, in today's video we're going to be painting a Chaos Knight from start to finish. But first of all I want to say a huge thank you to the guys over at Goblin Gaming who sent me the knight out for this tutorial. If you check the description box down below, I'll put a direct link to their web store, and also they have just launched their brand new YouTube channel, which I'll put a link to that as well. So please go over to their YouTube channel and subscribe for some great content that they've got coming up over the coming months. Okay guys, so I painted this knight up in 4 or 5 hours and I'm fairly happy with it, but given a lot more time you could get even better results than this. But as it is, we're going to show you how to get some really nice cool effects on your Chaos Knights really simply and really straightforward. But this is going to be a really long video. I think it's about 40 minutes, so go grab yourselves a nice hot drink or maybe an ice cold beer and we'll get started with the tutorial. I'll start off by priming all the areas that are due to be metallic in Alclad 2's Lacquer Primer Black. It's very important to note that you need to be well ventilated and have a respirator if you're using this lacquer. If you can't use this lacquer, then I highly recommend Steinor Res polyurethane primers. They're very, very good primers and they're a good alternative to Alclad primers. Okay, I'm painting in sub-assemblies here, so you'll see that I'm priming the legs separately and then I'll prime the body, and all the armor plates are not attached to the knight as at the moment. The reason for this is it's very awkward painting around the inner armor of the knight if you have those armor plates on the actual knight itself. So try and paint unites in sub-assemblies and you'll get a better result in the end. After priming all the areas of the knight in black that are due to be given a coat of a metallic finish, we're going to be painting with Vallejo Metal Colour Mainfold Old. Now this is a really nice metallic colour. It's got like a dingy browny tone undertone to it that looks really nice and is absolutely perfect for Chaos, as we don't want our knight to look pristine and in great condition. We want it to look like worn metallics. Same thing as before, just laying down a nice smooth coat, and we're laying down this Vallejo Metal Colour at about 18 psi. I'm avoiding the top surface of the carapace as that's due to be painted in a tan colour a little later on, but everywhere else on the body of the Knight is being painted with a manifold old colour. Normally I wash metallics with Norn oil, but again, because this is a Chaos Knight, we really want to make those metallics look as dingy as we possibly can. So I'm going to be using a heavy tint of Seraphim Sepia. And the reason I use the word tint, as it is more of a tint than a wash coming out of the airbrush, and it will change the overall hue of the metallics. Now we're going to dry brush all of the metallics with Vallejo Game Air Silver. This is a very bright colour, so make sure that when you are dry brushing that you've removed almost all of the paint from the bristles of the brush on some paper towel, and then you can actually slowly work backwards and forward with the bristles of the brush very gently just to catch the extreme edges of all those metallics. Now all the armor plates and also the top carapace of the Knight's body is going to be primed in Vallejo Surface Primer Desert Tan. Now this is being primed at about 20 psi here, and I'm being very careful not to go over any of the worked metallics that we've already done. But this is fairly easy as we're working just on this top carapace here, and it's very easy to avoid the metallics that we've already painted. Same thing here, just holding these as loosely as I possibly can, not to disturb the paintwork as I'm painting around it. And as you can see, it's going down really nice and smooth, spraying at about 20 psi. Now we're going to be spraying Vallejo Model Air 71270 White. Now I believe this is an off-white, but it says white on the label. So take particular note on the numbers of the bottle there, and you should find out that it is an off-white because it's not very bright indeed. And that's the color that we want. We want an off-white. And I'm spraying all the central panels of all those armor plates. We're going to be laying down some decals in a bit, and we're also going to be doing a panel line wash with some rust. So it's important that we lay down a nice gloss varnish finish for the decals to adhere to the surface as flat as possible, and for also the panel line wash to run as smoothly as it possibly can around the recesses of the panels. Here you can see that I'm using streaking rust effects, and I'm also going to be using AK Interactive's odorless thinner. I've recently been told that you can get odorless thinner in really large quantities from art supply stores, fairly cheap, so you don't have to get this AK Interactive odorless thinner, as I believe there is cheaper alternatives out there on the market. But anyway, I've thinned down the rust streaks about 1-to-1 with the odourless thinner to create a wash. And as you can see, I'm just touching the very extreme edges of all the panels, and the capillary action of the brush is drawing that wash all along those panels and making the work effortless. This is due in part to the gloss varnish. Here you can see that I'm doing exactly the same thing on the carapace of the knight, and we're just working all the way around those panels. And if I get too much of the streaking effect on any area that I don't want it, I then can come in with some odourless thinner and I can remove any of the rust streaks that I don't want on the surface of the miniature. After applying the decals onto the surface of the miniature, I'm now going to use Vallejo Premium Airbrush Colours Matte Varnish. As you can see, as I turn it around, it looks very garish with that really high gloss sheen. But instantly, as I airbrush that matte varnish, you can see it's got rid of the sheen on the decals and the sheen on the surface of the panels, and it's starting to look great already. Now we're going to create some chips on the surface of the model using Vallejo Game Air Charred Brown. You can also use Games Workshop's Rhinox Hide for this purpose, which also works very, very well. Here you can see that I'm using some blister foam from a miniature pack, and we're going to remove most of the paint on some paper there. And as soon as we can see that the chips are looking nice on the paper, we can then start adding the chips to the miniature. Now we're going to create some rust streaks using Odorless Thinner and MIG Ammo's Light Rust Wash. Now I have to admit, because I'm working fairly fast, that the rust streaks that I actually do, the streaks are too thick. You want the streaks to be as thin as possible to look in scale with the miniature. You'll see on the overall finish of the miniature at the end of the video, when you can see the knight finished in its entirety, that the streaks are a little thick in places. This is because I'm rushing to finish the knight ready for a tutorial. So if you can spend more time on your miniatures, then I highly recommend trying to get those streaks as thin and as smooth as possible. now we're going to use Green Stuff World's Dark Bronze. Now I think this is a fantastic colour, and this is going to give us some really nice looking bronze on the panels. I'm using a very large brush here, which can hold a lot of paint. It's a size 4 Artist Opus brush, and I can get really fast results with this paintbrush. But at the same time, if you've got longer to spend on your miniatures, use a slightly smaller brush and take your time, and you'll get even better results than I do. The Army Painter Strong Tone is going to be washed on all the areas that were painted in bronze. It's also going to be airbrushed onto the base of the miniature. The base of the miniature was originally base coated in Vallejo Game Air Earth. Now we're going to use Games Workshop's Technical Paint Nicolac Oxide. I absolutely love this effect to add patina to your miniatures. Obviously, on bronze it looks so good, but I have to add, guys, that you really need to be very sparing with this Nicolac Oxide. If you add too much, it can really overpower the miniature. I think I've added a little bit too much Nicolac Oxide to the finished miniature, personally, as I say, less is more with this particular paint. And here we can see our finished knight. I really love painting this knight, and as I said, there is a few things that I wish I would have done a little better, like making the streaks a little thinner, especially on the shoulder pauldrons of the knight. And also, I could have made the base a little bit more dynamic than just adding rubble to the base and a few tufts. But other than that, I think it's a decent paint job, guys, and one that I really hope you'll be able to follow along with this tutorial and replicate some of the results on your own Chaos Knights. Lastly, guys, I want to say a huge thank you to the guys over at Goblin Gaming once again. Don't forget to check their YouTube channel out, guys, and also their awesome web store. Links in the description box below for those. And thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.